All right, and we should be live right now.
Okay, so just get the little difficulty select screen.
Okay, whenever you're ready.
Okay. In 3, 2, 1, go. Hi. I'm Archie Helicopter, and this is Mibibli's Quest, any percent Mibibli. Mibibli being the main character of the game, and also the highest difficulty. And that's really the only difficulty that people speedrun for this game. This is a freeware 2D platformer, and it's a pretty weird game, so you'll probably be seeing a lot of stuff that you don't want to see, so strap in your seatbelts, I guess. The run is reasonably fast-paced. Mibibli is a pretty fast character in and of itself, and as the run goes on, we'll be getting some additional weapons, I guess, and also some extra movement options that speed up the game quite a bit. First level here, Arc Zone, it's a pretty technical level, honestly. Like, you wouldn't think that the first level would be already be one of the hardest levels in the run, but for some reason just is for me. Yeah, a lot of damage boosting in the start. When you damage boost, you go just as fast as when you walk, so it's basically a freebie always. Alright, so this is gonna look a little goofy. Right before I actually started the run itself, I activated a thing called speedrun mode, and speedrun mode basically causes the timer in the bottom right to appear, and it also makes it so that all cutscenes and scripted events are skipped, and because the first boss is also scripted, you get to skip a big chunk of just nothing appealing, so that's nice. Yeah, here in a city it's a bit of waiting, unfortunately. Throughout the run there are a few levels that are kinda weight heavy, like not just auto scrollers but also just rooms like that, but on the whole it balances out quite nicely, because the levels where you do get to go at full speed can go away pretty quickly sometimes. And so I'm gonna be coming up on the first boss here. In this game the bosses also have invincibility frames, and because you can only shoot 3 projectiles at a time, it becomes a lot more of a matter of actually trying to hit the boss when it's vulnerable instead of just straight up mashing like I'm doing now. So quite a few strats for especially the earlier bosses revolve around just not running out of bullets, because it can take quite a while before you can before one of the bullets despawns. Alright, nice. That first boss is the amount of time it takes to walk back and forth is random, and you want to be able to hit him 8 times, I guess, when it's running around, so I just barely got that. It is possible to actually get the get a 2 cycle if it jumps up earlier, but it's pretty hard and I generally don't get it. Come up on cave here. It's a lot of meshing, unfortunately. Not that great at meshing. So the glass here, if you hit it once, it breaks, and broken glass has like 60% damage. So gotta be a little bit careful, but usually works out just fine. Yo, got the 420 in-game time there. That's nice. Thank you. Ugh. Okay, this might be bad. It's bad. Dang. Yeah, that fly right there. The way these green flies work is that they only fly away when you get so close to them, and it's pretty hard to both pay attention to where the fly is and still meshing properly at the same time, so that can happen. Usually not that catastrophic though, but oh well, what can you do? Okay, that's better. Yeah, should be fine, I think. Yeah. If everything goes right, I won't have to take any damage anymore. But play the little save there. So we're getting pretty close to second boss here, Violent Rocket Lee. It's a pretty punishing boss, to be honest. Like, it shoots projectiles that crawl along the floor, and these projectiles turn you to stone and cost you a whole lot of time before you can move again. Yeah, here he is. So a lot of the jumping around that I'll be doing for this boss is really just to manipulate him into shooting these orbs in such a way that they won't really mess with me too much. So that should still be fine. I'm one hit lower, but one hit is okay. There we go. Right, so I guess I could talk a bit about the structure of this game. In this game, you divide it into three worlds, and for the first world we're in right now, we only have to beat 3 out of 4 levels, so we won't be seeing Rave. Right. Take that potion just for safety. It shouldn't be necessary, but being at full health here is nice. Yeah, Rave is a long time ago we did Rave, but then I then he properly started optimizing the run, and Cave just turned out better. Rave is also a lot more RNG than Cave, so City and question marks a lot faster. Right, so I don't like Simon Says, so we're gonna skip it. The weight that falls down does like 90% damage, I believe. So that's why I picked up the potion. The skips aren't really all that difficult, but the first one can kind of trip you up if you're not really paying attention. Yeah, just fortunately a bit of a boring part of the run, just holding the right button and thinking of stuff to say. Yeah, like I said earlier, the run in general is reasonably fast-paced, but there are just 2 or 3 of these instances where it's just you're not doing anything interesting for like a minute. So, just like one more screen before we head into World 2. Oops. Good thing I picked up a potion, because I think that would have killed me otherwise. And those flowers are random in where the flower petals go, so if you get really unlucky, you'll just get one shoved right in your face, and you don't want that. Right, so for we're in World 2 now, and at the end of every level in World 2 we get a different power up, and The order of levels here is basically just get the two really good ones first, and the rest are just small little details. Yeah, for this level we'll actually be going to set up for a thing called a game over warp. So I basically want to be at zero lives at the end of it. Nice. That setup right there allows you to die at the exact same moment as going to the next screen, so it saves a couple of seconds. It looks really, really precise, but the setup is super duper easy. Right. Just gonna get kinda airy, okay. That jump is always a pleasure to go through. It's reasonably lenient, but still scary. Okay, so this popcorn, I guess, or blood clots or whatever. The angle at which they fly is random, so hope I don't get fucked over here. Oh boy. Starting to get a little bit fishy. Ugh. Alright, that's a shame. Pretty sure I could have just stood there, but like, if you get a game over in a stage, you have to start from the beginning of the stage, and that's like a minute and a half lost that I didn't want to do. Like, I was actually planning to get off the platform before the ceiling got me as a safe strat, but I guess I was too late. So yeah, one heart attack later, or here. Yeah, here's the power-up that we picked up, the Explodash. It's a really fast movement option. It's also invincible throughout, so you can use it to go through enemies and spikes, and lets you make a lot of jumps that you otherwise wouldn't. So, prepare to hear that noise a lot. So here's the game over warp I was talking about. You normally after that that screen there's a oh wait. Go through the wrong level there. But after that screen there's a couple more screens for movement, and it takes quite a bit of time, so if dying three times is actually a couple of seconds faster. Yeah, the power of that we picked up there already comes in handy here. The cross lets you move up and down freely, and it's also invincible throughout, so there are quite a few screens in the game that are just really long and tedious, but can be skipped thanks to the cross. But you can only pick it up, you can only use it once per level, and then you have to pick it back up in the overworld. So here's a gas manipulate. It's this boss is the worst. It's really, really random in a lot of different aspects, in how high he goes up, in how long he stays up there, how long he stands raiding on the ground. But yeah, that gave me a really, really nice cycle there. But again, if gas manipulate wants you to, you can just lose 15 to 20 seconds. That's really uncommon though. Usually he behaves, but yeah, for that level I actually went to a secret exit, and that gives you the power-up version of this new weapon here, the Void Block. So come up on the suburb, you're already going to see why these first two power-ups are really, really good. The Void Block basically just insta-kills any enemy, normal enemy in the game, and it does double damage on bosses as well, so you're gonna be seeing it a lot. The the upgraded part, I guess, of the Void Block is that by going to that secret exit, you get to use this improved version, which has double the range of the regular void block. But if you if you're not at full health, you'll go back to the regular void block. And especially for quite a few bosses, that can be a big pain. Right. So this guy's being a bit of a meanie there. I tried to get a little setup here with like forcing him to jump at a specific spot, but as you can tell, Bibbly doesn't really have horizontal momentum, so if you don't get the setup immediately, you're basically fucked. It doesn't help that the visual cue for that is a bit wonky using the blades of grass. Yeah, we weapon we picked up there, the slugs, we'll be using that in like 4 screens of the game, I believe. Yeah, pretty sure it's 4. And basically to illustrate how much better the void block is. The slugs, they travel along the ground. There's one in front of you and behind you, but they travel really slowly and don't do double damage, so they're bad. So right here, what a nice example of void block doing double damage. Normally you have to damage it 6 times, but you can only hit it you only have to hit it 4 times if you know what you're doing. Really didn't want to get hit here because this boss uses a funky, really goofing looking damage boost for a fast shred. There we go. Yeah, so these projectiles that the boss launches, they insta-kill you. But luckily they don't spawn all the way to the right of the screen, so there's a little safe spot there. This was really, really, really horrible when we had to do it normally during a good run. So yeah, already if you just walk to the right and turn around, you won't be in the safe spot anymore, so yeah, scary stuff. Okay, so got the fire shield power up here. It's another power up that is affected by if you're on full health or not, and if you're not at full health, it's pretty much useless, but we'll be seeing some uses of it in a bit. Okay, so I didn't actually pick up the potion here, and that's because the boss of this level is actually slower with the super void block, so didn't want to be at full health. And another thing that I haven't mentioned, I guess, is that this game is timed by real time and not in-game time. So because whenever there's a little slowdown effect in this game, like when you beat a boss or something, the in-game timer slows down as well, but real time obviously doesn't. But that also happens when you pick up a potion, so there are 1 or 2 instances of the game where picking up the potion is faster for in-game time, but not for real time, so you just stick to real time for this. Okay, didn't want to. This boss is being a jerk right now. Okay. Yeah, when the boss attacks you from high like that, if you have the super void block, you'll overshoot it, and it takes a lot longer for the super void block to come back and as opposed to regular void block. So we because that boss it's random when it's vulnerable, you just prefer to just get it out of the way quickly and stick to low health. Yeah, again, didn't pick up the potion because this is a really, really, really fun auto-scroller. Blech. Yeah, this level is ugh, no thank you. Yeah, so, I guess here's the weapon we picked up before. It's takes forever to charge and doesn't do double damage, so it's shit. Yeah, we'll be using it for two screens in this level when that's probably the end of it. And so, one nice thing, I guess, of these auto-scrollers is that when the auto-scrollers end, the spikes on the right, they're just sort of stay put for a couple of minutes, couple of seconds, but luckily you can, if you explode dash through them, your body will already hit the area for the screen transition, so you can basically skip the end of an auto score like that. Okay, this spike is not cooperating right now. This spike doesn't actually insta-kill you, but I still don't want to get hit by it. Yeah, shoutouts to Uber Soul Medic for finding that neat little auto-scroller skip. It doesn't save a whole lot of time, but overall it does add up quite nicely. Yeah, here's another fun little glitch. We're going to turn invincible here. So, yeah, what's supposed to happen is these enemies are supposed to take a picture of you, and when they do, you're trapped in the frame and you have to mash out. But what happened there was I explode-dashed into it, and immediately after I got photographed, the game realizes that I'm supposed to be invincible, so it lets me out. But because the game doesn't properly finish the explode dash itself, it doesn't really register that I'm not supposed to be invincible anymore. But unfortunately, it wears off after you transition screens, so really the only use of it is that you get to skip the auto scroller nice and early. Right, so we're gonna see now why Fire Shield is useful. This is a reverse Croc Castle. I have to walk backwards here, and I also have to like hold left to go right. So it's kind of hard in this stage to adjust if anything goes wrong. But yeah, because I have to walk backwards, you can't really blast through things with your void block. But luckily, Fire Shield does the job. Does the job pretty well. Like, there are some enemies where for some reason you'll get hit when you try to kill them with the Fire Shield, but I don't really know why. But that doesn't really become an issue in this level. A lot nicer to go through this stage when you don't have to wait all the time. Right. Thought I was getting it there, but okay, good. The angle at which the charge stream shoots is random, and we use it there because it goes low enough to hit another batch of TNT, but when it doesn't hit it, it becomes quite difficult to implement a back up strat. Right, so that's Crocodibly. It's the boss you're supposed to see at the beginning of the game, but we skipped that obviously. Yeah, it can do three attacks after it's done flying around like that, and I got by far the fastest, so that was nice. We're gonna be seeing that boss again a bit later, but yeah, so here we got the mind missiles. They're not very useful. We'll be seeing that in one screen in the game. And it's next to weapons as well, by the way. Or for a really dumb and elaborate setup for someone else. But we'll get there when we get there. So here in Crystal Cars, I'd say it's the second hardest level in the game. It's a lot of cycles that you have to make, and you get uncomfortably close to quite a few batches of spikes, so always fun to go through. There we go. On the next stream here, we'll be... crap. That first... that fast thread right there is pretty funky. These... I saw these air blocks earlier in the Crumb ship, I believe, and it's pretty random if you can actually get the pieces that break off as well with the void block, and unfortunately I didn't get it. It might not make a big deal. The boss come up here has two different movement patterns at first, and one is really, really difficult if you don't have full health. Give me the good one. Ah, crap. Yeah, this is, oh boy. This is always terrible when you're not at full health. You have to get really, really close to the edge and jump up to hit him with the void block, so... Yeah, lots of spaghetti when you, get that pattern, but oh well. Like, if everything goes right, you can kill him right before it's moves around a second time, so it's really a pain. Yeah, we made it through, so it's alright, I guess. Alright, so come up here on the last stage of World 2, which water. You'd think that this level wouldn't be all that interesting because water levels usually aren't, but in this game they're kinda nice. Like this level a lot. Like, the water physics in this game make the already floaty controls even floatier, and it's just a blast to go through, I guess. This and the Subwarp are both really good levels for showing off just how fast the game can go if you have the if you know what you're doing and you have the proper tools. Just get... okay, got it. Looked a bit hairy, but it's fine. Yeah, that's already the end of the level. And so, this boss is barely any RNG. Only the bullets that shoots up are random. Yeah, we can just get it real fast like that. Alright, so since this is the last level of World 2, we're going to get an extra boss fight, and in this boss fight it's like in the stream before the boss fight you can also pick up the grass, so it's especially useful now to end on full health. Now we don't have to go left at all. There was a guy with a cannon strapped to his arm. It could have been a banana peel though. Knowing this game, it's not out of the realm of possibility. So for this boss, after when it gets below half health, it's goes up to his health bar to refill it, but it only checks if it's at half health after an attack. So I'll just take damage here. So what you can do is just take him just before health, half health, and just wait till its first attack is over, and then just kill it. Yeah, if he flies around in a nice pattern and also gives you the fastest attack like I got in Reverse Crocodile, so we can actually just kill it in one cycle. Yeah, I got a double jump there. It works kind of the same way as the regular jump in that it's you can pretty freely control its height, but and you're just using it to make higher jumps, I guess. Alright, so we're in World 3 now, and at this point the game just throws all conventions out the window. Like, until this point the levels have been really reasonably structured. Like, Every level has two checkpoints and then a boss, but for World 3 it's just do whatever and it hopefully works. Yeah, this level is also where stuff gets pretty crazy in terms of what's going on, so we're seeing a lot of fun stuff. Just using the ceiling as water there, and because water makes you fall a lot slower, you can go really, really far with the double jump and explode dash. Yeah, for this screen, it's just make sure that you measure appropriately to keep using the void block, and it's easy just like that. Yeah, so I suppose I could catch you guys up to the story, I guess. So we just traveled to the future to 7 days before Crocodiply dies, and we want to see him dead so bad that we're just going to stall for time for a week. So it's just going through a regular work week for good old Bibli here. Fun, fun, fun. This game is from 2014, I believe. Made by one guy, though. And it's free, It's always a good reason to get the game. Alright, so here's Friday. I'd say the hardest level in the run. Pretty much everything here either insta-kills you or deals half damage, and you have to want to be doing a damage boost at the end of this, so can't get hit. So right here, because the timer is white, you can't really see it properly against the background, so the developer has to put in a an additional tile in the tile set, I guess. But he forgot to make it not solid, so you can just stand up there. Alright, so a bit of a funky stuff going up. Alright, good. So the waterfalls here give you extra vertical momentum, and that's it's also the case for the cross. You can just go up really quickly there. Right, so the fallout here is random, and if the game is really mean to me, it just throws out a bunch of slow flakes right in front of, right in the middle there. But the developer released this game on itch.io first, and it later got a Steam re-release, but it's still free on itch.io, if I remember correctly. There is some extra content in the Steam version, but you can actually just play any percent on the free version. So, coming up is my absolute favorite part of the game. It's a 3.5 minute space shooter auto scroller. Yeah. So yeah, can't speed this stuff up at all, so enjoy the next 3 minutes of your life, I guess. I know I won't, so make up for me. Yeah, if you just want to play the game and see if you like it, I suggest just getting the free version first and supporting the developer if you like later. So at the end of this level there's a boss, and thing with this level is it's right before the boss there's a checkpoint, and it's the only checkpoint in the game where if you get a game over, you'll respawn right back at the checkpoint instead of beginning of the level, like pretty much all all other checkpoints in this game. But when you take a hit here, it's instant death. So, and if you die here, you also lose the power-ups that you got here. And as you can probably tell, the full power-up is quite a lot faster than the vanilla one. So you really don't want to die at the boss. Like, if I do die to the boss, I usually just take the full game over and be done with it. And just start the fight over. Yeah, one sad part about that though is that for whatever reason, if you continue there, the music doesn't go back, so you're just stuck to the sound of Mabibli shooting his laser for quite a while. Yeah, this trice only honestly isn't too difficult, but usually when I get there here I'm really, really nervous, so I've been known to choke here quite a bit. Especially that second attack, and just the ship can move up and down reasonably freely, so if you're not careful you can get hit there. This looks easy, then that's because it is. Just, generally pretty scared of it. Should be it though. Yeah, because in this level the rule of limited amount of shots still applies. You don't want to stay too far to the left because obviously you won't be able to kill the boss quite as fast. So you have to take a little bit of a risk, but he turns out alright. Alright, so here's Tuesday. It's the level here has a screen wrap mechanic in some screens, so it's gonna look a little goofy at times. Yeah, here are the other weapons. Well, kinda scary. Yeah, because there aren't any enemies on this screen, you can still shoot the homing missiles, and they're still active when you do, so they just fall down on the blocks. Yeah, that allows us to set up the crystals there, and that in turn allows us to stay full health throughout that little block section and go faster. Yeah, that's the only thing you'll be seeing of those other three weapons, I guess. It just goes to show, I guess, how much how good the void block is. You just have to. You can only really use the other weapons for such elaborate setups. Should be the end of Thursday, Tuesday rather. Alright, so come up on Saturday. It's a really, really boring level, just nothing interesting here, so you can just look away for half a minute and not miss anything, I promise. Just walking right and jumping and explodishing and nothing else. It's just really, really uneventful, so yeah, luckily it's not too long. So now that we're done with just frolicking through a field of flowers, we can really be coming up on the last level of the game someday. It actually starts off with the boss, and the boss can be kinda annoying. It has three different attacks, and the way it moves around before that can be kinda hard to actually predict and play around, so it's okay if I lose health here. Like, Really, the only downside is that... Oh boy. Yeah, there's the only downside is that I have to get closer to him now, and that makes me quite a bit more vulnerable. Oh boy. Kinda scary. Alright, good. Alright. So yeah, for this part you're supposed to use the slogs and they crawl around on the floor and reveal the path, but I already know the path, so I don't need it. Yeah, we're pretty much at the end of the game. Time is when in a couple of screens. Alright, so just a little bit more movement and then we're done. Time is when I collect the big one. You'll know it when we get there. Step skip, step skip. Nice. So now all we have to do is pillage Quirkadibbly's cores and steal his toupee and beat the game. Time.
Congrats.
Oh, thanks. What was the final time?
41.04.
Oh, not bad. I expected a whole lot worse, to be honest. I would have almost been world record, I think, if it weren't for that really painful death in cave.
Aw.
Oh well. Yeah, thanks y'all for watching. It's hope y'all had fun. I had quite a bit of fun as well.